Hey Ravens, welcome to this week's episode of ONW Now. I'm Lena Saturin alongside Lily Beckwith.
Today we'll take a look at a local dog rescue and adoption agency.
We'll also bring you a story of one family's journey with CBD oil.
And the final episode of Mystery Matchmaker. Can't wait to see who Natalie picks.
All right, Ravens, let's get it started.
Kansas City is currently in an extreme blood shortage, and Olathe Northwest did their part by hosting a blood drive on February 12th. We received close to 200 pints of blood from students, teachers, and outside donors. Although a little less than last year, we had a great turnout.
It's really important that everybody donates blood because everyone's a different blood type, and the people who, you know, need blood transfers or they need blood donations, you know, need it for all different reasons. So everyone can help no matter, you know, what blood type you are or like when you're donating. So it's really important that the most possible people get here.
Thank you to all who donated blood to benefit others in the KC Metro.
Last week, Orchestra held at the movies their themed concert. Paige Gerstner has the story.
Last Tuesday, the ONW Orchestra had their annual themed concert at the movies, featuring songs from Star Wars, Coco, Pirates of the Caribbean, and many more.
My favorite part of the concert today was Lord of the Rings. I really liked it. I'm obsessed with Lord of the Rings, and I thought the music sounded really good.
This concert is held every year to show off the freshman, concert, and advanced orchestra's playing skills.
As a player, I think this benefited us because we just like came together as a group and just sounded a lot better.
Not only does it further expand students' playing skills, it develops teamwork skills as well.
My favorite part about the concert is probably when Mr. Martin had a bunch of people dress up and walk around the crowd.
For ONW Now, this has been Paige Gerstner.
Awesome job, you guys sounded great.
Next up, we have a story about one busy student and how she balances her time with various extracurricular activities.
For many athletes, it can be difficult to get involved. Balancing athletics, academics, and extracurricular activities can be a struggle. So we sat down with Olivia Markey to get some tips on managing the busy lifestyle.
It's definitely a lot of like just time management. I try to get like as much homework as I can done at school. I definitely have to like prioritize different things. So like my job comes first. I think it's important just to like try and get everything done and not leave it off till the last minute.
Being a part of Raven Lacrosse, choir, theater, and e-communications herself, there are many benefits to being involved.
It looks very good on like applications and things like that. And I also like just get to know a lot of different people, and I just feel pretty like fulfilled, so.
The benefits are extremely worth the dedicated time and work athletes put in, such as developing time management and life skills early on, and plenty of scholarships and relationships.
Sometimes it's nice to get like a full 8 hours of sleep, but like it's kind of nice just like having something to do all the time.
Rolanda Daniel and the rest of the SID team, this has been Jenna Doherty and Riley Moore. Now back to the desk.
In 2005, the Basset and Beagle Rescue of the Heartland opened in hopes to give Basset Hounds and Beagle mixes a second chance at life. Let's take it to Savannah Capps for the story.
We have fostered approximately 36 dogs in the last couple of years. Some of them for as short as a week, they're in and out, and our longest one we had for a year. I'm currently fostering 5. However, when we started, we fostered one at a time.
Fostering dogs is a very rewarding experience, and in many cases, you end up saving a life.
Knowing that you are helping a dog that might otherwise have been euthanized, watching them develop and grow. We have one little foster right now that we've had for 6 months. He was either severely abused or had no idea what people were. He will now eat food out of my hand. He'll let me pet his cheek while he's eating food. He'll get all excited with the other dogs and come running up to me. I can't pet him yet, but he doesn't run from me and he doesn't bark from me. And when he first came, if you even tried to lean over and touch him, he would try to bite your hands off. Every rescue group in the country is always looking for fosters. It doesn't cost you anything. All of the food, all of the treats, all of the medical expenses are all covered through BBRH.
There are many opportunities to get involved with BBRH, such as volunteering, fostering, transporting, donating, or even adopting.
We fostered Buddy through BBRH, which is a Basset and Beagle rescue. He was going to be put down because he wasn't getting adopted. Figured he was probably about one. He was very puppyish. And so when you get a dog to foster, you have to bring them home and spend a little bit of time with them and see what their needs are, see what their strengths are, so that you could write a biography for them to post on the website so someone else can adopt them. Our dog loved having another dog around, and we all loved another dog around as well.
For more information on BBRH and how you can get involved, visit bassetandbeagle.org. For ONW Now, this has been Savannah Capps.
Next, let's take a look at a local family's journey with CBD oil to help with epilepsy.
Very, and I think even the neurologist was surprised at the results that we were seeing for our son. He was really struggling a few years ago, and we were struggling with finding things to help him. And so it's been life-changing for him to be able to just function and thrive.
Eli McCullough has had epilepsy his entire life, causing him to take large amounts of medication until his family started using CBD oil.
The medical marijuana has both components, and CBD oil just has the CBD portion, which does not have the THC, which would make somebody high.
While CBD oil is legal in Kansas, there are many obstacles to using it.
So a doctor isn't able to, because it's not a prescription, so a doctor isn't able to prescribe an amount or for use. So.
The legalization of marijuana is a controversial topic pressing our nation today, and Tammy believes that it is important for everyone to be educated on this topic.
I think it's important for high schoolers because there was a lot of misconceptions with medical marijuana and with the different components of the marijuana plant. And so just being educated with that, because marijuana is still illegal, still a drug. I think it's important for high school students to, you know, understand the legalities of.
Tammy believes that if medicinal marijuana were to be legalized, more studies would be done and more people would see the benefits of CBD oil.
I think there would be. I think there's a lot of potential for a lot of different types of. I know there's been some studies looking into children with autism, and there's already a lot of evidence with children with severe epilepsy. They just, there's a new pharmaceutical drug that just was went through testing over the summer and was approved by the FDA it's for two very specific epilepsy syndromes. There's I think there's potentially a lot of benefits for lots of different neurological conditions and disorders that they're finding. So.
To see the full-length documentary and the written article, check out our website at onwravendaily.com. For ONW Now, this has been Rosie Boswell.
Now let's throw it over to game day for an update on Raven Athletics.
Hey Ravens, I'm Jenna Doherty, and welcome to today's Game Day Northwest. We've got a lot for you in this beautiful love day, so let's get rolling. Our bowling team competed in the Sunflower League meet at Olathe Lanes East. Both JV boys and girls placed second overall. The varsity team started off slow, but then picked up the pace. The girls placed top five and the boys placed third. Cameron Kotswich placed 10 in the whole meet. The city meet is this Friday at Olathe Lanes East. Last Saturday, our Raven wrestling team competed in the Sunflower League meet at Lawrence Free State. Vlad Honk and Iliab Tefera finished sixth. Quinton Talbert and Cade Conover placed fourth. Nick Savage placed third. John Redman finished second. And Brady Pellman and Caden Howard finished first. The team as a whole placed fourth out of 14 teams. The next time our Ravens compete on the mat will be this weekend at regionals. On Tuesday, the boys basketball team competed against Gardner-Edgerton on our home court. Our Ravens started off incredibly strong but fell short to the Trailblazers, losing 47-36. Our Lady Ravens also hosted the Trailblazers on Tuesday. The girls maintained control of the whole game, winning 70-47. Both boys and girls will be having their senior night at 7 o'clock tonight here at ONW. Sometimes sports can get kind of serious, but these Raven fans wanted to have some fun with their favorite Raven athletes.
Bryce Johnson looks like Baby Brent from Cloudy with a Chance of Meatballs. Thanks, guy. That's
a lot. Chase Franks can't dance. I mean, that's probably true. I can't dance.
Mary Reaver's basketball career is almost as short as she is. Wow, I'm butthurt.
D-Gore's jump shot is almost as broke as people without AirPods. D gets more kisses from Coach Grove than he does his own girlfriend.
Haley McCormick is single-handedly louder than the entire ONW student section at games. Thanks.
Zade Dejani looks like Woody from Toy Story. Howdy.
Andrew Dumas looks like a Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle. Huh. What's that? I'd be Raphael if I had to. Yeah.
I could throw Jack Clayton further than he can hit a baseball.
Mia Haight got first team all league forward last year, but my grandma could score more goals than her.
Gage Hunsaker looks like Nick from Big Mouth. Nice.
And that wraps up today's Game Day Northwest. For Landon Daniel and the rest of the SID team, I'm Jenna Doherty, and happy Valentine's Day. Now back to the desk.
Now it's time for everyone's favorite segment, the last episode of Mystery Matchmaker.
Hey Ravens, and welcome to the finale of everyone's favorite show, Mystery Matchmaker. Just in case you missed our last episode, we'll give you a little recap. Last week, Natalie and her five mystery men were separated by a wall, while Natalie asked them some personal questions.
After talking to all the guys, Natalie decided which two guys will be moving on to this final round.
Okay, I think I have the top two. Flirty Cuddlebug and Lovey Cutie Pie. All of Flirty Cuddlebug and Lovey Cutie Pie's answers were about me, so. Sorry to the three boys that got eliminated, but Lovey Cutie Pie and Flirty Cuddlebug really stepped their game up this week.
Now for this episode, Natalie will be talking to both Flirty Cuddlebug and Lovey Cutie Pie over a romantic dinner, but with a sheet over both of the boys.
Let's take a look at their conversations.
So I sat down with Flirty Cuddlebug and Lovey Cutie Pie and just asked them some questions over Pop-Tarts and Goldfish and...
Feels really good.
We can just have a normal conversation with this.
You think?
Yeah. So, how do your goldfish taste?
They're pretty good.
So, if you were to get arrested, what would you get arrested for?
Stealing your heart from someone else.
Okay, I got a good one.
Okay.
You ready?
Mm-hmm.
Chipotle or Panda Express?
Panda Express.
How did I get this far?
I think everything happens for a reason, and maybe you could be the one.
I feel pretty good about making it to this round. I think I performed very well in the past rounds. Secure here with a couple freckle quotes. Winning this would make me so happy. I know she's my dream girl already. Natalie, I'll see you soon.
Yeah. Okay, what are three things you'd save in a fire?
Wait, are you in the fire too?
Sure.
Yeah, I'd save you, I'd save my phone, and I'd save like a bunch of money.
Alright, what's your favorite type of pizza?
Oh, definitely pepperoni.
Do you like pineapple on your pizza?
Never had it actually before.
Yeah, neither have I, so.
Maybe we should go do that.
Yeah, maybe.
What do you look for in a person?
Definitely take a look at their personality first, and then their looks probably second.
Yeah, good answer. How do you feel about making it this far?
Pretty good. I think my chances are pretty high. I think I secured the bag.
Now that Natalie has gotten to know the two mystery men a little bit better, we asked them both about their final thoughts.
Okay, so Flirty Cuddlebug didn't really seem too interested in me, and Lovey Cutie Pie had more answers that seemed more interested in me.
Now for the moment everyone has been waiting for, Natalie will decide between Flirty Cuddlebug and Lovey Cutie Pie. Let's take a look at which lucky mystery guy has won over her heart.
Okay, so I think I'm gonna pick Lovey Cutie Pie for the winner. Okay, it's one of the winners.
of figured it out, and then I was like asking people.
I saw you in the holes. Remember, like, last time we recorded, you walked by and I was sitting down.
Yeah, I did. I didn't know then, so I didn't even.
Congratulations to Levy Cutify, aka Dylan Cooper. We wish you and Natalie the best of luck. And sorry to Bryce Johnson. Better luck next time.
Thanks for watching, Ravens. This has been Nina Rice
and Anna Marie Struck.
Thanks for watching Mystery Matchmaker. We'll see you next time.
You know, I'm so glad that Dylan won. He was the obvious choice. I mean, like, freshman year me is shook.
I mean, I was really rooting for Bryce. The mullet really got me.
All right, Ravens. Don't forget that before halftime at tonight's basketball game, Raven Service Club and Eagle Service Club are competing to see which school can raise the most money for pennies for patients. So bring your spare change to help ONW win back our spirit stick.
That's it for us, Ravens. Make sure to check out our Instagram, Twitter, and YouTube channel at ONW Raven Daily. And be sure to check out our brand new website, theravendaily.com, for all your school news.
For Lily Beckwith and Landon Daniel, this has been Lena Saturin. We'll see you next week.
Thanks for watching!
Can you see the tape in
that? No. By the way, Nina spent $3 on this. She wants you all to know. $3, ladies. All right.
This has been a wonderful experience.
Stop.
Holy.
Last week, Natalie and the five mystery men talked. Now that Natalie has gotten to know the two mystery men, Hayden.
Now for the moment you all have been waiting for, Natalie has to build her camera. Natalie will decide between Levy Cutie Pie and Flirt with Crew. Natalie will decide between Levy Cutie Pie and Flirt with Crew.
Why can't I say it?
This is my first long line.
She's never stood in a line before.
I have like all of
shut all right. Up! Okay.
That looks so scary. Okay, we're fine.
I have a girlfriend, but I'm sitting here to see.
I felt silly.
Here are our sunglasses. All right, thanks for watching Mystery Matchmaker. It's been Anna Marie Struck and Nina Rice behind the camera.